remember it. Now, deep it fouled up around the bar.
I have no bones in the coal miner's child. You know that one, don't you? At the door of a rich man's hall, she trembling stood on the marble steps and leaned on the polished wall. My father was killed in the coal mine, she said, as the tears dimmed her eyes so bright.
That's done without a coal miner line to it, too, isn't it?
That's the orphan child.
But this is the coal miner version of the orphan child. Where did you hear that, or is that?
No, I think I learned this from Daddy.
Yeah, that's the way I heard it. In fact,
this is the way you heard it.
Gammy sings it as orphan girl.
Right.
But the coal miner punchlines were picked up in Kentucky somewhere.
Yeah. There's also a record by Sarah Ogden Gunning that's re-released on Folk Legacy that has a lot of miner songs on it.
What is her name?
Sarah Ogden Gunning. She's the sister of Aunt Molly Jackson. And what's the brother's name? What's that guy's name? Jim Garland.
Jim Garland, yeah.
A brother of
hers. But I didn't know that this woman has a record of her own.
Yeah. She was younger than the rest of them.
Still in print?
Oh, yeah.
She's younger.
I think so. Maybe he is.
Oh, they just found her in the last few years.
No, she was collected by a folklorist named Ellen Steckert someplace. And that must have been about 10 years ago when she was collected.
Wow.
The words. He copied down the words. It was on an old piece of paper that I still have when he was in jail in KJ.
Mm-hmm. Seems to me, I don't know, there are places where the old Coal Creek explosion, some of the songs and some of the words.
There's a lot of songs about Coal Creek collected by various folklorists. One is, what is that guy's name? Ed Kahn. he now does the same Ken. He's the K-A-H-N from UCLA. And I think Archie Green has put out a document, a little monograph on poetry. And Buddy, once you roll down the lines about poetry, not the explosion, about a strike.
The strike, poetry. Go ahead. Archie Green is still at Illinois, you think?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Urbana.
Urbana, right.
Okay.
I think Cold Creek's name has changed to Mountain City or something like that. It's no longer Cold Creek. Cold Creek March, that's just a banjo solo without any words.
You know it?
No. I think it's Pete Steele that's played by. There's documentary records at any rate of that one. I'll get the banjo and play them.
How do you remember all the words you have
sung them for so often?
Oh, yeah. Grand on the Miners, a whole group of people singing coal miner songs on Channel 13.
Oscar Bennett wasn't likely to be good. Was it good? Because he's just lousy.
Well, it was simply, and I think it was done in West Virginia, the locale. want to check that. It was on.
No, Oscar Brand is who? Let me identify him.
What do you say?
Sort of Broadway folk style.
Yeah.
Well, but he's a.
And they had a you think a West Virginia collection of coal mine songs on 13.
It was some of West Virginia.
13 is educational.
Right. So Oscar Brown was there. He was in a coal mine in West Virginia with all the miners.
I didn't know that. Yeah. I don't know any coal mine in which they stand around singing folk songs. They staged it that way.
He's very slick. This guy.
But he sings beautifully.
He's very slick. He doesn't sing well.
But he stages these beautiful things, though.
Well, people sing with him may sing well.
He's very knowledgeable. I don't know enough about him.
Well, wait a minute. Let me go back to the sister, because she was starting to tell me what this is at the Dunning.
Gunning,
yeah.
Sarah Ogden Gunning.
What is she like? Where does she live?
I don't know where she lives, but she's just
married?
Very friendly. She's ex-married. Her husband was a miner who died.
What kind of things did she write about?
About mining conditions. One of them is sort of, let me tell you what it's like to be a miner, and my kids had pellagra, and my husband died of black lung, and she's...
How recently did she do these things?
In the 30s.
I see.
And I met her in the 60s.
Where was she at that time?
In the 30s?
No, in the 60s when you met her.
New York.
I see.
She'd come up for a concert. Mm-hmm. Where she was living, I don't know. But she'd be easy to get a hold of just by writing Folk Legacy, Sharon, Connecticut. Mm-hmm. That's the full address. But just Sandy Payton.
Who handles that?
Yeah. He runs the record company. P-A-T-O-N.
Okay. Now you're going to do one with the banjo.
One girl that is contemporary and young and whose family were miners writes fantastically good songs about the mines. Hazel Dickens is her name.
She's on the West Coast now?
No, she's on the East Coast. I think she lives in Baltimore. Mm-hmm. She writes really great songs.
New ones? Where are they appearing?
Well, she sings them. So one of the songs was used on a documentary recently about the mines too. Where can you get in contact with her? Through Alice Foster, or through through Ralph Renzler. A lot of people know her address. I'll give you somebody's address who will know her address.
And what was this on the West Coast? This was a...
This is a club called the Ash Grove. It's run by a kooky man named Ed Pearl.
What part of the West Coast is that?
Los Angeles. And he's always, always doing something that he can see is considered as important and left and revolutionary.
Now, what were they would have brought a bunch of artists together to just do that?
Alice sang there, I sang there, Mike Seeger sang there, everybody that knows minor songs came and sang minor songs there.
All at one?
And there were some documentaries, films shown. No, it was a series of performances.
How about these people that are singers with, I don't want to characterize them, but they sing for the Council of Southern Mountains and all, like Mike Klein, and familiar with him and his sidekick?
Yeah, his two records?
No, I may have, a little 45s?
No, they're big LPs.
No,
Can't Put It Back is one of them.
Yeah, I've heard him do that, along with a visual presentation. Is that something common he does?
Well, he's organized one visual presentation.
I heard his message. You saw that at Berea.
Yeah. Yeah, and he has two LPs that he's put out.
What are they, you know?
Stuff he's written mostly about mines. And
mostly he's very topical, like he'll do today's black lung issue or this strip mining issue, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, is this what this girl's doing, or is she reminiscing to...
It's much more emotional and much, much more personal with her, and it's a little more interesting. I think it has more body, more substance than Mike. Mike's sort of a here today, gone tomorrow.
Yeah, who is with Mike Klein? What's the other?
Rick somebody?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't remember his last name.
I'm not replacing him either. Oh, you're giving me a good anthology.
You can go on.
No, it is. You're very knowledgeable, and I wouldn't... you know, I might think of one here or one there. I wouldn't have any idea of the whole field as you do. Probably a beginning point is to look up everything that Archie Green has written and published.
Mm-hmm. That's probably for me.
On April 30th, in 1933, on the streets of Wilder, they shot him brave and free. They shot my darling father, he fell upon the ground. Was in the back they shot him, blood came screaming down. They took their pistol hands and beat him on the head. The hired gunman beat him till he was cold and dead. When he left home that morning, I thought he'd soon return. But for my darling father, my heart will ever yearn. We took him to the graveyard and there we laid him down to sleep in death for many a year in the cold and sodden ground. Although he left the Union, he tried so hard to build. His blood was spilled for justice, and justice guides us still.
Now, where'd you learn that?
Well, the tune of it, I guess, I learned from Daddy, and I don't know why I learned it, because Della Mae Graham, who was supposed to have written it, who apparently did write it, wrote it as a poem. And I don't know who put the music to it. Greenway has another tune to it.
Who?
Greenway.
It's in his book.
But it's a completely incomprehensible, sort of illiterate tune. It doesn't make any sense musically. I don't know where that is.
Yeah. And this is 33, so this is it's Harlan or Belgium.
It's Wilder, Tennessee.
Wilder, Tennessee, oh. Do you know anything about the Everts? Was there anything ever? Everts
no,
in Kentucky? You never heard of that?
No. There's a...
There was some such stuff in 33. They had violence. 33.
Why
did
you
use
tablecloth? Wash it, fold it up, no iron.
I got the blues.
you had David.
I was trying to remember the words in your head.
Well, the brother said you've got it. Two more times.
B-O-W-L-E-S.
That's part of this same Davis Wilder.
Yeah. And he stopped L.L. Shivers from putting the third cut on. Mm-hmm.
That should be in there. She should be talking into that.
I live in a town way down south. Buffalo. I work in the mill with the rest of the tribe, as we're all called now. We work from weekend to weekend and never lose a day till that awful payday comes and we draw our little.
Oh, yeah. I think
there's now that is that the that must be in Buffalo, South Carolina.
I guess so.
And that's like that hard
it's
work.
Collected
in the mills. What's the hard times in the mills?
Mills, my love, hard times.
Remember, I first heard that from the girl in the mill that came out of. I think Summer School Board.
Try to get a record if you want some cotton mill songs put out by Testament Records. If you write. What is his name? Pete Wheeling, I think, at UCLA. It's his record company. It's very tiny, and it's a record of Dorsey Dixon playing the songs he wrote. He wrote a lot of mill songs.
Timely. He wrote them now?
No, he was writing in the 30s. Here's one of his.
I used to be a factory hand when things were moving slow. Oh.
Knott's poem. I don't know. Somebody might have put it. The golf links lie so near the mill that almost every day the laboring children can look out and see the men at play. That's the song, you know, the poem that was so effective in this challenge. But that Hard Times in the Mill was a real folk song, I think. As far as I know, that wasn't made up topically, or at least I found people singing it in the 30s. It really, like you'd ask them where they learned it, they'd learned it a long time ago.
Mm-hmm. Every morning, just about 5, get up, children, dead or alive, it's hard times. Hard times in the year. When I go to work every morning at 6, I find my job in an awful fix. It's hard times. Dalhart sang.
Back in the 30s?
I must have been in
the 30s. Yeah, it's a depression song. Because it's farm relief, you know.
Yes.
That's a good one, lively.
Yeah. That's a nice one. I think I learned that from a Hillbilly Records from his thing. It's really an industrial song.
What do you find in England and Wales? Are there any, are there mining songs more distinctive that you've heard? Mm-hmm. Are they more localized? You know, the Welsh are set, reputedly such good singers. I wonder if it's related to any of that. There's so many mining songs.
I haven't heard any Welsh mining songs. I've heard British mining songs. Mm-hmm. And they're not changed for the Hillbilly market. Our music is all changed. It's not much... it's perhaps folk, but it's changed by theatrical music and stage music, traveling shows, and what became Hillbilly music. Theirs is still traditional sounding. They have some really beautiful ones.
You know any of them?
I never did learn them, but I just thought of another...
source, huh?
Another mining song.
Oh, good.
There's a records put out of those British songs, though.
Are they? Do you think
Lloyd would know about them.
Okay. Now, how do you contact, is it A.L.?
A.L. Lloyd, uh-huh. L-L-O-Y-D, 16, Crooms, C-R-O-O-M-S, Hill, London, Southeast 10.
Do you memorize all these famous
no.
people? Okay, he's so special. He's the best collector.
He's a good singer, too.
Is he?
Let's
what
see.
Age man is he?
70. He's pretty active, too.
See, there's hope for all of us, then.
Hope so.
You have to become a folk singer. You've got three more years. Pick up folk singing. You can do that for that. Which one are you going
to
sing now?
I'm trying to remember. It's on the banjo.
Yeah, it's a banjo one.
Yeah.
Okay. You're switching, getting your little picks on your fingers and then going.
I didn't need them, then.
Didn't need them.
It's a British song, but collected in America. I think also by Corson. Still, there's still versions in England of it. It's prettier there in England.
Now, what was she saying in there that her son had died?
No, her boyfriend, her fiancé. He'd come from Ireland, apparently. His name was Murphy. Mm-hmm. And he came to work in northwest Scotland in the mines. Mm-hmm. And there was a mine explosion and died.
Mm-hmm. Right. The Corson describes in the anthracite part, where he's described more how he went about it, that this folks ballad singing was a real business in bars, you know, and all. So there were guys, a lot of ex-miners made their living, and
really?
He wrote biographies about it in the appendix, you know. And but that would be taking on the trappings of what you're talking about already. They begin to pick up modern whatever you said there.
Yeah, well, no American folk song was immune to it. Even the people that sang it was sang traditionally good. Our whole folk music got changed by professional music.
Uh-huh. Well, let me ask you about something else. The national groupings, like Nat just gave me the Greeks in Utah. That's a group I wasn't aware of. Terribly significant, very large national group in the Utah coal mines.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm aware of it in most parts of Appalachia, what the national groupings were. I take it nothing survived to that. They might have had their own native national song. Greeks apparently used songs to preserve their own national identity against the Turks, and also they sung a great deal, but I can't imagine much of it having survived except as a national kind of ethnic thing.
I don't ever understand you quite.
Well, I'm wondering if their mining experience amended them in any way, you know. Many of these Italian groups, there's almost every nationality that at some point in some place was big around the mines.
Mm-hmm.
And we're talking about collecting songs in English. And what I'm wondering is whether anybody would have noticed whether they had added to their own national songs, you know, something from this.
But Corson collected some. Oh, that's the bell for me. Corson collected some songs in other languages. I think I have to go down yet.